Let's talk about this entity called biliary atresia. What do you have in this? Why do you need to worry in pediatrics about this? Basically, a neonate presenting with jaundice, we are evaluating. Biliary atresia is the destructive sclerosing inflammatory process where there is a obstruction of the extrahepatic bile duct. See, doctor, hepatocytes will be giving rise to biliary radicals which will converge and form biliary duct. And that biliary duct, once it comes out of the liver, you have extrahepatic. Within the liver, you call intrahepatic. Now, we are clear with our anatomy, right? Now, there is an obstruction of the extrahepatic bile ducts in biliary atresia, and by about 6 to 10 weeks of age, the portal pressure will typically increase and finally biliary cirrhosis will occur in these patients who have biliary atresia. But when do you worry about this condition and suspect it? By about second week in preterm, by about second week you expect physiological jaundice to resolve. If it is prolonging, you think of this. And all that jaundice is what kind of jaundice? Cholestatic jaundice. Because the problem is in the biliary duct, which is atretic. So that lead to development of conjugated bilirubin enter into urine and lead to development of a yellow colored urine. But the bilirubin cannot enter into gut. Unless it enters into gut, stools don't get stained. So you have got acolic stools classically with conjugated hyperbilirubinemia with a colored urine because of the conjugated hyperbilirubinemia. And always any infant who remains jaundiced beyond 14th day, you should basically think of this. How is the liver pathologically, basically? There is a marked cholestasis with intrahepatic bile duct proliferation, fibrosis and cirrhosis. That is the histology in these individuals. Microscopically, you have lot of brown-green bile plugs with bile duct proliferation and extensive fibrosis. That's what you come across. Now, why you need to worry about this? We earlier read a topic called neonatal giant cell hepatitis. Idiopathic neonatal hepatitis, na? That is a differential diagnosis for the biliary atresia is what we need to understand. But histologically in that condition you have giant cells. Whereas histologically in the case of the biliary atresia, what do you have? You have got extensive fibrosis, bile duct proliferation, etc., etc. So how do you prove this? You have to do a percutaneous liver biopsy and presence of that bile duct atretic lesions is an important proof with cholestasis without giant cells is biliary atresia. And they can develop cholangitis, portal hypertension can develop. Now how do you cure this condition? Simple. Liver is conjugating bilirubin, no problem. But that conjugated bilirubin is unable to pass through the bile duct because the extrahepatic bile duct is atretic. So bypass that and then directly connect the liver with the jejunum. So which is called Kasai's procedure, and liver transplantation is considered to be the treatment of choice. Now the second important entity we need to talk about is choledochal cyst. What is this? Once more, it is extrahepatic biliary system mein problem hai. क्या प्रॉब्लम है? वो एट्रिटिक नहीं है. देयर इज ए डायलटेशन ऑफ इट लाइक एन एनियरिज्मल डायलटेशन, सिस्टिक डायलटेशन ऑफ इट इज देयर. नाउ वेयर कैन दैट डायलटेशन कैन बी लोकेटेड? इन एक्स्ट्राहेपेटिक. एक्स्ट्राहेपेटिक बिलियरी सिस्टम मींस व्हाट डज इट हैव? कॉमन बाइल डक्ट, लेफ्ट बाइल डक्ट, राइट बाइल डक्ट, अंटिल इट गोस एंड एम्प्टीज इनटू एम्पिल ऑफ वाटर. Accordingly, where is that cyst located will decide it as type 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But for entrance, what is needed? Most common type of choledochal cyst out of all this is type 1, where in the common bile duct you have got the presence of this kind of a cystic lesion is what you need to basically remember. It's more common in females and it can progress to cirrhosis. It can lead to upper abdominal pain and upper quadrant mass it can present like. And it can be silent throughout the childhood, and when the girl entered her first year MBBS or first year BSc or BCom, that time she presents with jaundice, and when you have evaluated, you discovered choledochal cyst. That's how it can present. Female predominant condition, basically. If you do operatively, you can see the presence of a choledochal cyst as what you can see here, and you can do a DICIDA or PIPIDA radionuclide scan, which can demonstrate the collection of the radionuclide dye within that cystic dilatation is what is considered to be diagnostic. If you do operative cholangiogram, then you can see the fusiform dilatation of the common bile duct, where you have the presence of the choledochal cyst. This is another example of a choledochal cyst typically arising from the common bile duct is what you can see here. And sometimes one of the complications of the choledochal cyst is what? It can lead to development of a concomitant pancreatitis. So here you have the choledochal cyst arising from the biliary system, and here you have got the inflammatory edematous pancreas with pancreatitis. So one of the complications of the choledochal cyst. So once more to summarize for you, doctor, you all know of course that there is a hepatic duct, there is a common bile duct, and there is a gallbladder leaving a cystic duct, there is a portal vein, there is a hepatic artery, there is a duodenum. The portal triad, where we are located. Then basically type 1 means there is a dilatation of the common bile duct. Type 2 means on the side wall of the biliary duct. Accordingly we divide it, but type 1 is most common. So dilatation of the common bile duct is the type 1, which is the commonest variety. Now what complications are there if you leave the choledochal cyst? If it is, can we leave it? It can lead to inflammation of the biliary tree. Cholangitis can occur. It can lead to cyst to undergo rupture. It can lead to pancreatitis. It can lead to gallstones. It can lead to carcinoma of the biliary tree. Cholangiocarcinoma can occur because of the choledochal cyst. Why to have it? Remove it. That is going to be the treatment of choice. And it can lead to recurrent upper abdominal pain, recurrent jaundice, and a palpable cystic mass. Any of them can be the presentation. So how do you treat it? Simple. Every time, what is the common thing you have? If there is a traffic jam in Koti, you will go through Bashirbagh. So it is a Rook's NY loop of biliary drainage. So you will be basically taking a loop which is connecting directly the river with the jejunum. So Rook's NY jejunostomy is NY loop is what you basically do to create a drainage bypassing the choledochal cyst and common bile duct, which is obstructed by this choledochal cyst.